At this point, you need to have finished installing Xcode. So if you haven't yet, pause this video and take a moment to finish the installation. Since I already have Xcode installed, I'm ready to launch the Maze application. To launch the app, we need to first launch Xcode. And you can do this by clicking on the spotlight icon in the top right-hand corner of the screen, or optionally, you can hit Command and then Space, and that'll bring up the same spotlight search, and then type Xcode. This will bring up the Xcode launch screen. From the launch screen, you can create new Xcode projects, open existing projects, or create a playground. We won't quite be using playgrounds yet, but they're a great tool for experimenting and writing Swift code. For now, you'll want to open an existing Xcode project, the Maze project to be precise. We've created the Maze project ahead of time for you, so if you haven't downloaded it already, go ahead and download it first before continuing ahead. Once you've downloaded the project and saved it somewhere on your computer, select Open Another Project, and then you'll want to navigate to the project. So I've saved it on my desktop, and you'll want to open up the Xcode project file. And we'll give it a second to load. And here we go. This is Xcode. It's a huge application, so we'll start taking it one piece at a time. To run the Maze application, click on the Play button in the upper left-hand corner of the Xcode interface. You may also hear this button referred to as the Run button. This will launch the iOS simulator with the Maze app. And there we go. Congratulations, you've launched your first app.